Guten Tag and welcome to Hockenheim, home of the German Grand Prix, for today's practice session. It's a big weekend for a number of our top drivers as they look for success on home soil. We'll be getting underway shortly to see how they get on. Now then, Anthony Davidson, there's been a lot of talk over the last few weeks about track limits. How much is too much when you're cutting corners and running wide? What are your thoughts on this? And do you think we'll be seeing drivers pushing those limits this weekend?
Well, I'd be disappointed if we didn't, frankly. If race control want to clamp down on drivers wandering off the track, then it's up to them to police it. As a driver, you're being paid to get your car around the circuit as quickly as possible, don't forget. So if you're not pushing those limits, if you're ignoring the advantageous line, then you're not doing your job properly. Now, I agree that, you know, we have these white lines there for a reason, and we do want to see those limits enforced, but for me, it's not a driver's responsibility to do that.
Chance of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know. To run during these practice sessions, you can check the details in the car monitor. We'll get good data for both the race and factory teams, so they're well worth running. first, build up speed later.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three. Vettel, Hamilton and Max Verstappen. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds.
Hi, it's Emma. Your qualifying goals came up in the board meeting this morning. Here's what to expect.
Welcome to Germany for today's qualifying session at the famous Hockenheim Ring. The pit lane lights will turn green in the next minute or two to signify the start of qualifying. This is a track that tends to ask quite a lot of the tyres, both front and rear. So is it fair to say a great deal of management will be needed in order to do well here?
Tyre wear is always something you have to consider to a certain degree. Finding a good car balance that suits the circuit will help prolong the life of the tyre, but it's true that some circuits, such as this one, are more challenging than others. How hard you can push them depends on your strategy and how tight the battle is around you.
We don't need to push too hard in this session. We should have the pace to qualify easily. Sebastian sat in P4 at the moment. Set us back a little. So far is a 1:15.1.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. A Ferrari, Vettel, and Nico Rosberg. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix. We have an incredibly competitive field this year, which means we should be in for a treat. And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me. We're racing in the Rhine Valley this weekend, at the home of many of the sport's finest competitors. The 2.8-mile Hockenheim Ring requires precision through the technical stadium section and great raw speed down the long, flat-out curve towards the popular overtaking zone of the Turn 6 hairpin. Watch out for a lot of wheel-to-wheel action there today. I, for one, can't wait to get started. And there's another very excited little chap here beside me as well. It's our very own Anthony Davidson. great to see you again today.
Thanks for that, Crofty. And I'm really anxious to get underway here. We've got all the makings of a great race today. World champions in competitive cars, lots of drivers on form, and I suspect a few strategists on the pit wall looking to try something a bit different and maybe jump their cars up the order.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Try to cover the inside line off the start.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. It's Ferrari in pole position then, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Rosberg, Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton, and Ricciardo, Bottas, Alonso, Massa, and Jenson Button, Magnussen, Perez, Carlos Sainz, and Gutierrez, Kvyat, Hülkenberg, Jolyon Palmer, and Marcus Ericsson, Wehrlein, and Harry Anto. Felipe Nasser and Roman Grosjean starts from the back of the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Thank you.
first position, front of the pack. Your pit window opens in 2 laps time, 17 laps to go. Sebastian stopped. His race is over. Perez is in first place.
Seconds.
amps of fuel remaining.
So another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well though, there's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
Well, this is it. This is where they all want to be. Here come the top three then, out onto the podium after a fascinating Grand Prix. Let's take a look at the driver's standings. Nico Rosberg takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after that excellent result. Moving on to the driver of the day then, Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
It's got to be Romain Grosjean. He was in another league for me today, really impressive.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us and goodbye until the next race.